Teacher Joni.
Hi, Teacher Teal. What are you doing on Saturday?
Oh, didn't you hear what's happening at church on Saturday?
No. What's happening?
It's Trunkformation Night.
Oh, why does that name sound so familiar?
Well, it used to be called Reformation Night.
Oh, what is Reformation Night?
Well, Teacher Joni, I'm glad you asked.
Hi, Sprouts. Today we'll be learning about the Reformation, but before we get into our lesson, Teacher Joni is going to pray for us.
Okay, let's close our eyes, bow our heads, and fold our hands. Dear God, thank you for today and for this opportunity that we can worship you through singing praises, praying, and learning about how the Christian church came to be. I pray that you would continue to grow our love, faith, and knowledge of you, and that we will have open hearts and be focused as we go over today's lesson. May you be with us today. In your name I pray, amen.
Okay, so today, as we said already, we'll be learning about the Reformation. So what we'll be going over is first, who started the Reformation? Second, why did it happen? And third, what were the results of the Reformation? So, it all began with this guy named Martin Luther. How many of you guys have ever heard of Martin Luther? All right, well, if you don't know who he is, Martin Luther was a monk in the time where the Catholic Church was the most dominant institution, and this was in the 1500s, so over 500 years ago. However, Martin Luther had some doubts and differing views from what the Catholic Church taught, and so he challenged the Catholic Church's authority and teachings. At the time, the Catholic Church was telling people that they could only have salvation through works, specifically by purchasing these things called indulgences. Luther believed that salvation could not be earned through works, but only by God's grace through faith in Christ Jesus. So, he wrote the 95 Theses, which were a list of reasons why the Catholic Church was corrupt and going against God's word, and he nailed it to the door of Wittenberg's Castle Church. And as a result, Luther caused the start of the Reformation. Let's review. So why did the Reformation happen? It all began because the Catholic Church was distorting church doctrine and saying that people had to buy their salvation. But this is wrong. Luther called for the purification of the church and reliance on the Bible, God's word.
Now, what were the results of the Reformation? Let's take a look at these five ideas that encompass what Luther was fighting for. First is sola gratia, which means by grace alone. Do you guys know what grace is? Grace is when you receive something that you don't deserve. Like if you broke your mom's favorite plate, but your mom doesn't get mad and forgives you and even buys you a piece of candy. You didn't deserve the candy, but your mom showed you grace. Likewise, we believe that we didn't deserve God's love or salvation because we are sinful. But by God's grace, he extended his love to us, forgave us, and offered the gift of salvation. Next, sola fide, and that means by faith alone. Faith is believing in what you cannot see. For example, you have faith that when you sit on a chair, the chair will hold you and not fall on the ground, even though you cannot see the nails and screws that are holding the chair together. Likewise, we have faith that God sent his Son, Jesus, to die for our sins and raised him from the dead, though we were not there, but we believe. Third, solus Christus, through Christ alone. We believe that salvation is only through Christ's sacrifice on the cross for us and not by anything we can do on our own. Fourth, sola scriptura, scripture alone. The Bible is God's word, and we believe that it is 100% true and the highest authority because God spoke these words. This means that we submit and live according to what the Bible says, rather than what other people may say. Lastly, soli Deo Gloria, to the glory of God alone. We live for God alone. We do not live for ourselves or for other people, but only for God.
So now we prepared a little song for you guys to hopefully help you remember these five solas, which again are the ideas that came from the Reformation. Watch out for the end because you're gonna have to help us sing too.
Martin Luther, a monk in 1517, was unhappy with the Catholic Church and made a scene. Introduced the five solas, of which we'll learn and sing. These remind Christians of their faith in the gracious King.
First is sola gratia, by grace alone. We're saved by God's grace, not by works we've shown. Second, sola fide, faith alone. By faith we're made righteous, through the blood of Jesus.
Third is solus Christus, Christ alone, our one and only King. Let our praises ring. Fourth is sola scriptura, the Bible alone. It is God's authoritative word. Word.
Fifth is soli Deo Gloria, we live for God alone, not for myself or anyone.
Sola gratia,
sola gratia,
sola fide,
sola fide,
solus Christus,
solus Christus,
sola scriptura,
sola scriptura,
soli Deo Gloria,
soli Deo Gloria.
Okay, now kids, repeat after me. Sola gratia,
sola gratia,
sola fide,
sola fide,
solus Christus,
solus Christus,
sola scriptura,
sola scriptura,
soli Deo Gloria,
soli Deo Gloria.
Okay, now one more time. Sola gratia,
sola gratia,
sola fide,
sola fide,
solus Christus,
solus Christus,
sola scriptura,
sola scriptura,
soli Deo Gloria,
soli Deo Gloria.
Yay! Good job. Good job.
Okay, guys, now we are going to close this lesson in a word of prayer. So remember, let's close our eyes and bow our heads and fold our hands into our laps. Dear God, thank you for this time that we had to learn about Martin Luther and the Reformation. We are thankful that you have extended grace to us so that if we have faith in Christ, we are saved and can have a relationship with you. We thank you for your word that is living and active, and we pray that our lives would be used for you, for you are deserving of all the glory. We pray that you'll be with us and our families for the rest of this week, and we love you. In your son's name we pray, amen.
let's go to the guy and girl part. I will not be shaken.